I thought of another rule. So I'm a journalist, I'm a freelancer, and recently I've been writing for a new magazine called Restaurant Technology Magazine because my mom is the editor. I actually interviewed a vice president of White Castle, and I talked to him for about 8 minutes, and he used the word crave about 12 times. So I would say to people talking to the media, talk like a person. My first love in my life is public radio. I do some work with WFYI. I went to a special school to learn how to be a public radio storyteller. It's called the Salt Institute, and it's in Portland, Maine. And I want to tell you about my struggle of producing my first story. We had to produce 2 radio documentaries, 6 minutes long. And one of them was actually working with a photographer. We also did an audio slideshow. So my photographer buddy and I, we were trying to do different things, and nothing was, we really wanted to interview a sex worker, and actually met her in a Panera where she meets her clients. And she was awesome, but she wouldn't let me, she was afraid of people recognizing her voice. She really just wanted to print, so that didn't work. So we sent out like a cry for help on Facebook. Our friends posted to their friends, and we found out about a dog rescue that would take dogs from unwanted dogs from Georgia through the South all the way up to Portland, Maine. And we're like, okay, we can do this. And but the problem was there were all these different elements to this story. So there were the guys who drove this RV full of dogs from Georgia to Maine and back every other weekend. And then there were the people in Maine who had the rescue, who were fostering the dogs. So we go up and we interview this woman and her husband, and we, you know, hang out with their dog and their foster dog, and you know, it's a little bit of a tension in that dynamic. And we went up to an event at a tractor supply company in which it was a fundraiser for the organization. And there were just, it was kind of like Best in Show, which I hadn't seen at the time. There was a woman who had a dog whose name was like Chandler Trailer Chavez Tim Duliola Jones. And then there were people who only got another dog to be a friend to their first dog. Like, you know, the more rural you, this is rural, the more rural you get, the more dogs there are and the bigger they are. So I come in and I have all these elements and all these scenes, and my teacher, my classmates, my great teacher, Rob Rosenthal, he used a concept that was called circling the stadium. Like, you have this idea, but you haven't really found the story. What can you tell succinctly in 6 minutes or whatever time you have? And I had all these pieces of transcript and script, and my fellow students were like, wait a minute, there's a van full of dogs. They drive from Georgia to Maine in a weekend. They're like, just get on the van. It's all about the van. And they were absolutely right. I drove down, like 2 hours down, to some place in New Hampshire, and I get on, the dogs come off, I see the happy families, I get on, I talk to them while it's rolling, you know, I get all the road sound, and then my photographer did it at a separate time, and it turned out to be, you know, a decent, heartwarming story. It was a father-son tale, and I got to ride with them to their very last stop, where the only place they actually go is to go to Walmart in Maine for like half an hour, and then they turn around and drive back, and there was a man there who had driven 5 hours from New Brunswick, Canada. He had a ridiculous accent. He adopted some kind of a coon hound, and he was like, they beller and they squeak and they make all kinds of noise. I know I'm making him sound southern, but it was just a really weird accent. I made this comparison in the story to online dating. It was so touching that these guys came all the way from Georgia. He came from another country just to get like this one kind of dog that he knew he would love. And it was a good starting story. And I think the moral of this story is editing is so important. Honestly, thank you.